All right, so continuing on with this example, so here I want to make a note that I am getting the user selection, and then I want to check for valid input. And I can do that by doing kind of the same thing we did earlier, checking for valid input for whether they want to play again or not, but I can say as long as they didn't enter something valid. So while they didn't enter something valid, well, what's valid? The only two things that are valid are one or a two in this case. And so I can say while the user pick was not equal to a one and the user pick was not equal to a 2. Again, the same logic here. You might be tempted to use an or there because it's not a 1 or it's not a 2. But the problem is that doesn't work with the computer logic because, again, if you pick a 1, that's not a 2. And if you're using an or, then either one satisfies it. And so it'll ask him for valid input, even though technically it was valid input. So that's why we need to use an and, or alternatively, we could just set up the whole situation. We could say, while it's not, user pick is equal to a 1, or user pick is equal to a 2. So while it's not the situation that the user picked a 1 or a 2, whichever way makes more sense to you. For me, I kind of like the other way, and maybe that's just because it's what I'm used to. Okay, so while it's not valid input though, then I want to print out and say invalid pick, whatever I said in the pseudocode. Let me go back to the pseudocode. Invalid input, try again. Okay, so invalid input, try again. Enter 1 for heads or 2 for tails. Okay, and then we'll get their input again. So user pick equals in dot next int. Okay, and again, I don't need to comment every line, but it's nice to have a little note there to see what I'm doing in this section so I don't have to try and go through and read the code and figure it out. Okay, so back to our pseudocode. After we've gotten the input, then we need to simulate the actual flipping of the coin. Okay, so simulate the coin flip. And we do that by getting a random number. Now, I haven't included a random number generator in this program yet, so I'm going to come back up to the top. I'm going to import the java.util.random class. And then I'm going to build a random number generator, which I'll do just below the scanner. I kind of like to group these things together. It makes it easier. Well, I don't want to be a new scanner. That was a mistake. I want to be a new random, and then nothing goes in the parentheses for the random, at least for our purposes. Okay, so now I've got my scanner and my random classes built so I can use them. Now back into the program. And to simulate the coin flip, I've got a variable already set up for it that I called flipResult. And so I'm going to say, let's set flipResult equal to a random number out of how many different options? Well, it's heads or tails, so we have two different options. Now this is going to give me a 0 and a 1, right? That's two different options, but it's only going to give me a 0 or 1. If I want it to be a 1 or a 2 to kind of match what I said here with 1 for heads and 2 for tails, then after I've gotten that flip result, then I want to add 1 to it. So now it'll be a 1 or a 2 that comes out of the result. And I don't need any error checking for this, at least in terms of a while statement. We'll talk about other types of error checking. But this gives me a 1 or a 2, and that's all it will ever be, is a 1 or a 2. And so That's the simulating the flip of the coin. Okay, so what are we going to do next? Well, then we need to increment the number of flips, and I can just do that along with this, and maybe make a note, simulate coin flip and increase the count of games. Okay, so then up here I have a number of flips variable that I can increment. So I'm going to take number of flips and increment that by one each time I flip the coin. Okay, so what are we going to do next? Well, now we need to make our decision. So we can check and print results in this next section of code. So now's where we're going to have a bunch of if statements. And then I probably ought to make a comment down here. See if the user wants to continue, something like that. And then this can be a note down here, check for valid input. Okay, so we don't want too many comments, but it's kind of nice to just kind of walk the user through the program of what's going on. And then I'm trying to be good about indentation and kind of spacing and grouping, all with this idea that it's going to make it easier to read in the end. Okay, so how do we check for and print the results? Well, we first said if the user picked heads and the coin flip was heads. So really, I can kind of do a shortcut here because I've set it up to where the coin flip, the user pick is going to be a 1 or a 2, and the flip result is going to be a 1 or a 2. So if the flip, if they're the same, I'm just realizing, then it doesn't matter. They win if they're the same. And so if the user pick is equal to the flip result, then I can print out system.out.println, you win. All right, so now I'm modifying my pseudocode here. To do the pseudocode, I would just say if the user pick, let's see, is equal to a 1, and the flip result is equal to a 1, then I can do it that way too, whichever way you feel more comfortable. But just as I was going through this in my mind, and this is what happens in programming, I realized, well, I've got this situation where they're either equal or they aren't, and that's going to determine whether the user wins or loses. And so I can say, if the user pick is equal to the flip result, I'm trying to decide if that's going to bother you or not, that I just changed from our pseudocode. But this is the shorter way of doing it, right? And we like shortcuts. Then you win. Else, meaning they're not the same, then system.out.println, you lose. Now, what did we miss here? Well, we didn't pick whether that was heads or tails, so we need to make a decision after we've simulated the coin flip of what it actually was. And so I can say if what? So if something, then I'm going to print it was heads. Okay. And then if it was something else, then I'm going to print it was tails. Okay, so what's the something? Well, we've got our flip result. So I say if the flip result is equal to a 1, then we're going to print out it was heads. If the flip result equals a 2, then we're going to print it was tails. Now, why didn't I just use an if-else statement? Well, I could have. But it was just as easy in my mind to do it this way, and that way if the result came out to be 0 somehow or 5 or something, it wouldn't print out anything, and I'd say, well, there's something wrong with my program. Okay, so that's part of the simulating the coin flips. So now I say if the flip result, if it's the same, then you win, otherwise you lose. And then the other part is, if we win, what do we need to do? Well, according to our pseudocode, which I need to go back and modify now, but I'm going to increase the number of wins every time I win. And so I've got this variable that I've set up here for number of wins, that if I win, I want to increment number of wins. Okay. All right. Now, I'm already anticipating there will be one problem, but the last little part of our pseudocode after we've finished the game is to print out the number of wins and the number of flips, and then print that's the percentage. Okay, so what do I do? Well, so I'm going to print game results now here after the game has ended. So I'm going to system.out.println and say you won, and then space, concatenate on the number of wins. And then I'm going to go down to the next line so I don't run off the page. I have my plus there on the end, so this will work. Out of, and then concatenate. The number of flips. And then I'll concatenate on the word games. Okay, and then to get the percentage, then I'm going to say system.out.println, and I just realized this is going to cause us some trouble, but that'll be good for review purposes. That's, and then concatenate on the percentage. So the percentage is going to be the number of wins divided by the number of flips, and then I'll concatenate on the percentage sign. Okay, let's test this thing out. I'm already anticipating a couple of problems we're going to have when we run this, but that's the basic structure of the game. So we run this, enter one hit for heads or two for tails, and I'll say one, and notice what it did. It said it was tails, you lose, play again, and then it just jumped ahead and said invalid input, try again, play again. I mean, it looks like the program's gone nuts. Well, this is a good example to show us that we need to flush the buffer. We've skipped ahead all of a sudden in the program, and that's because up here, when we asked for the user input, they're entering a 1 or a 2. That's a number. They'll read in the integer, but that leaves an enter stroke out in the buffer. So now when I get down here at the bottom to my next line, or actually right there, next line, then it's just as if the user pressed the enter key. So before we get that result, we need to flush the buffer. And we do that by just doing an in.nextLine, not reading it into anywhere, but just reading everything out of the buffer. Okay, let's try that. It was tails, you lose. I entered a 1, play again, yes. It was tails, you lose, play again, yes. Hopefully I can get a heads here. It was tails, okay. I'm starting to wonder if there's something wrong. Okay, there we get a heads. So it was heads, you win, play again, yes or no. And if I say no, then I won 1 out of 4 games. Well, first of all, I see I need to add a space there on the games. But then I also see that's 0%. Well, that's not good. Why am I getting 0%? And maybe I'm trying to keep these things under 15 minutes, and so maybe rather than addressing that, I will have to jump into one last little video to finish out this program. So we'll go ahead and do that and look at the last little part of why we're getting a 0% there in the last part. Spencer out.